So, there's a difference, right? She paused and pushed the tip of her tongue forwards. Her lower lip bulging, she ran her tongue across her teeth, made a smack, and continued, "In how things are experienced. The surroundings running across my retina sucked me into the widest perspective. I took it all in. Even the stains in the right corner contrasted the eggshell color, no longer disturbed me. My eyeballs dried up, just like they do when viewing a dull landscape painting hanging on some bare wall in some rich motherfucker's house. Decoration, it is called, and some ask for it," he launched out. "It reminds me of the time I left, out the door, nothing but thuds down the stairs, happy to be let off. You were surprised, I knew. You wouldn't have expected that, but if you had asked me, did I ever see it coming, I would answer you in the bluntest way of all. Getting carried away now, I remember you. Above all, I remember you. Allow me to recap. Maybe I don't burn so bad for you anymore," you said into the cold air. At this moment, the moon turned all surrounding bright. You must have been dressed for something else. Your tanned arms, stick-like, pinning out from those big sleeves, hanging straight down toward the ground, as if weights were dropping from the very bottom of your being, spreading gossip about you and your desires, about where you might have gone traveling. The only thing in my vision was the carpet of snow shining like a million diamonds against the black night sky. I remember your long coat and how we had walked home together right after you had asked me if we should take on the night, full length, no stopping. Years later, you had told me you had felt like your soul present were to turn me bad, as if your gang tattoo were to be a symbol of repulsion and fear, as if I were to be someone pure, and as if you were to be a Christian. All of this seems ridiculous to me now, though. Whitened bone structure and black mud tar slime are the ones who live through the winter's night. I wonder how it will ever be okay. Such a betrayal at such a speed, sharp stabs right into the bloody heart. I wonder if she had ever known jealousy, if she had ever known pain. He stands there with his back against you. Is he about to leave? I remember the weeks before as the longest wait ever. Waking up in the morning, grabbing a cup, filling it with coffee. If you had been there, you would have seen the hallway on the right side. Following it, you would have been led to the smoker's room, exiting the balcony from the kitchen on the back side. One could see big old oaks. We sat there one evening. You came to visit. There's a small room in the basement. The smell in the underground is raw. You'll have to get used to it. The creak in the door pulls the cold inside. The night sweat dries eventually. It sticks to the body like a thin layer of poison and revenge, seeping through millions of pores, sneaking out and passing the border into the dark blue night. The covers of the mattress are damp. When the sun is shining, you prefer the shadow, I noticed. She is sitting so still and quiet, resting on her heels. I look down to her legs, her calves turned outward a bit, revealing flesh in the shape of an oval shell. Her tendon must be long and soft, I thought, just observing her from a distance. We are staring out the window. Am I scared? It is not even a question. There are no reasons right now, here, where we are sitting. It doesn't look like you are trying, or maybe that's it. You are trying too hard, babe. Could it have been that you had walked the magical rocky landscape of the island? That place where we had sunbathed? Had you been back to those places where we rolled around like kids in the sand until dawn, I wondered. The tall grass is moving in a slow-paced dance. Alerting the dry sand, making them move, wakes me up. The small swirls of caramel-colored particles tickling themselves into continuum, flattened when the sea rose and the sun set, ran across the land. The warm wind felt like silk against my skin, and my head felt warm and light. Should you just not dwell in it for a day and a night? Go back to your old habits, pick it up right where you fucking left it. Wouldn't that just be peachy? Bathe your inner monster in tranquilizers and dream your life away. Sail away to the greatest ocean. Dive into it. Take a risk, like be the dolphin. Sleek and sulky against the water, he breaks the surface. From the tiny raft you are sitting on, you can see his shiny eyes, right? Take the dive, go back into the sea, and this time do not hold on to any ropes. This time freestyle dive, so that when the dolphins again talk, when one of them moves in that fast way, showcasing his many small sharp teeth, I fall in love all over again.
I would give up. Preoccupations of the old desiring mind. Enter unwavering. The experience of the clarity of the precepts. About to lose this created body of flesh and blood. I will realize it to be an impermanent illusion. Hey, now. When the reality between dawns upon me, I will let go of the hallucinations of instinctive terror. Enter the realization of all objects as my mind's own visions. And then understand this as a pattern of perception in the between. Come to this moment, arrive at this most critical cessation. I will not fear my own visions of deities. Mild and fierce. Hey, now. When the existence between dawns upon me, I will hold my will with mind one-pointed. And increase forcefully the impulse of positive evolution. Now, blocking the womb door, I will remember to be revulsed. Now, courage and positive perception are essential. I'll give up envy. And contemplate all couples as my spiritual mentor, father and mother. Without ever thinking, death is coming. without ever thinking death is coming. Slave away on the pointless business of mundane life, and then to come out empty. It is a tragic error. So, why don't you live this divine truth from now on? These are the words of the great adepts. If you don't put the master's precepts in your mind, won't you be the one who deceives yourself? Hey, now, when the life between dawns upon me, I will give up laziness, as life has no more time. Unwavering, enter the path of learning, thinking, meditating, and taking perception and mind as a path. I will realize the three bodies of enlightenment. This once that I have obtained the human body is not the time to stay on the path of distractions. Hey, now, when the dream between dawns upon me, I'll give up corpse-like sleeping in delusion and mindfully enter unwavering the experience of reality, conscious of dreaming, I will enjoy the changes as clear light. Not sleeping mindlessly like an animal. I will enjoy the practice, merging sleep and realization. Hey. Now when the meditation between dawns upon me, I will abandon the preoccupations of the old desiring mind. Enter, unwavering, the experience of the clarity of the precepts, and transmitigate into that boundless space of inner awareness. About to lose this created body, flesh, and blood. I will realize it to be an impermanent illusion. Of instinctive terror. I will let go of the hallucinations of instinctive terror. I will let go of the hallucinations of instinctive terror. Understand this. essential. Now, courage. Positive perception. Contemplate. All couples as my spiritual, mental father and mother. Without ever thinking death is coming, slave away on the pointless business of mundane life, and then to come out empty. It is a tragic error. So why won't you live this divine truth from now on? These are words by the great adepts. If you don't put your mentor's precepts in your mind, won't you be the one who deceives yourself? Hey, now, when the life between dawns upon me, I will give up laziness as life has no more time, unwavering, enter the path of learning, thinking, meditating, and taking perception and mind as path. I will realize the three bodies of enlightenment. This once that I have obtained the human body is not the time to stay on the path of distractions. Hey, now when the dream between dawns upon me, I will give up corpse-like sleeping in delusion and mindfully enter unwavering the experience of reality. Conscious of sleeping, I will enjoy the changes as clear light, not sleeping mindlessly like an animal. I will cherish the practice merging sleep and realization. Now, when the meditation between dawns upon me, I will abandon the host of distracting errors. Focus on extreme, free experience without releasing or controlling. And achieve stability in the creation and perfection stages. Now giving up business, one pointed in meditation. I won't surrender to the power of erroneous addictions. Now, when the death point between dawns upon me, I will give up the preoccupations of the old desiring mind. Enter unwavering the experience of the clarity of the precepts and transmitigate into this birthless space of inner awareness. About to lose this created body of flesh and blood, I will realize it to be an impermanent illusion. Hey. Now, when the reality between dawns upon me, I let go of the hallucinations of instinctive terror. Enter the realization of all objects as my mind's own visions. And understand this as a pattern of the perception of the between. Come to this moment. Arrive at this most critical cessation. I will not fear my visions of deities mild and fierce. Hey, now, when the existence between dawns upon me, I will increase forcefully the impulse of positive evolution. Blocking the womb door, I will remember to be revulsed. Now, courage. And positive perception are essential. I'll give up envy and contemplate all couples as my own spiritual, mental father and mother. Without ever thinking death is coming. To slave away on the pointless business of mundane life and then to come out empty. It's tragic error. So won't you live this divine truth from now on? These are the words by the great adepts. If you don't put the master's precepts in your mind, won't you be the one who deceives yourself? Thank you. dawns upon me, I will. Let go of the hallucinations of instinctive terror. And all objects, as my mind's own visions, and understand this as a pattern of perception in the between. Come to this moment. Arrived at this most critical cessation. I will not fear my own visions of deities mild and fierce. They now in the existence between. Dawns upon me. I will hold my will with mind one pointed. And increase forcefully the impulse of positive evolution. Courage and realization are essential. Locking the one door, I will remember to be revulsed. I'll contemplate all couples as my spiritual mentor. Father and mother, without ever thinking death is coming. To slave away on the mundane business of pointless business of mundane life, and then to come out empty is a tragic error. So won't you live this divine truth from now on? Thank you. These are the words by the great adepts. If you don't put the master's precepts in your mind, won't you be the one who deceives yourself?